Nobody's ever happy in here. No, it's depressing, sadness.
It's crazy down there, so you be careful, man, when you go there at nighttime.
既然没有人喜欢住进森林，却又为什么有那么多人住进来呢？答案可能就来自于他们背后的故事。走进这个全美最大的无家可归者宿营地，我们独家采访了两位刚出狱不久的居民。
5月17日 ，Emmanuel 刚刚度过自己37岁的生日。从组装电筒到改装家具 ，Emmanuel 无所不精通。他说，如果不是犯罪，他现在应该是一名科学家了。
I mean, tell you the truth, like I said, there's no future for me, there's no plan for me, like, my life is done. One day, I am kicked out of this country as I speak right now. They're just waiting to get an embassy. But as soon as they take me back, I know I'm a dead man, you know what I mean? Because I betrayed my country, you know?
Emmanuel 来自伊拉克的巴格达，全家都是托马斯基督徒。于是受到伊斯兰教的压迫，在母亲被绑架并杀害之后，父亲带着 Emmanuel 四兄妹逃到美国。1996年，伊曼鲁顺利在苗必达高中毕业，可惜在被帮派分子吸纳之后，走上了不归路。
Coming over here, you know, 1989, I was 9 years old, and you know, just my dad became very, very abusive. I turned to the streets.The streets, you know, the gang members, their families took me in, you know, they welcomed me in. I don't want to be at the house. And then, you know, it just started from there.
Emmanuel 是圣何西的北丹尼尔帮派成员，曾犯下盗窃、持械抢劫等重罪，入狱超过15年。他背着两次重罪记录，根据加州的三镇出局法例，只要他再有任何行为不检，就会自动被判无期徒刑。
It took me damn near 15 years to finally realize I'm 37 today. And it took me that long to realize that, you know what? I don't have to make no more trouble, you know what I mean? It's okay. I can live the life like this. Even though I'm not happy, at least I'm not in jail, you know?
离 Emmanuel 的帐篷不到50米。住着另一个无家可归者罗尼。90天前，带着性犯罪者记录的罗尼刚刚假释出狱。20年的铁窗生涯让他对外面的世界感到陌生。
I became something I didn't even know I was going to become. Angry, ornery, mean, nasty, evil, spiteful, hateful. I changed the person that I was 20 years ago, man, to what you see today.
至今，罗尼仍然坚决表示。自己从来没有性骚扰任何人，他是冤枉的。
26 years ago, I caught a case with a girlfriend. I was 17 and I was 20, and her boss called the cops, and I went down and gave my side of the story, and I was charged for a sex offense, but it was non-registered a sex offense. The past 20 years, I've had to register. I've caught 2 prison terms behind it. They tried to kill me once behind it, and now the laws have changed where you can't live anywhere as a sex offender without 2,000 feet of a park or a school.Well, there just about is nowhere for anybody to live.
接受采访的时候，罗尼脚上仍然带着跟踪仪。由于有登记强奸案底，无论是找房还是找工作，罗尼都处处碰壁。最后，森林收留了他。伊曼鲁搭建这个新家花了整整2天时间。他的帐篷是记者见过在森林里最富有人性化设计的住所。一房一厅，厨房和洗手间齐全。主人殷勤地向记者演示他新发明的自动门。自动门的旁边装有门铃和门牌。宽敞的客厅内摆着一张写意的沙滩椅。伊曼鲁在自己的帐篷前挖了一个坑，在里面点燃柴火，用作主食。如果嫌烧柴太麻烦，这里还有一个小火炉。能用作日常的烘焙。采访当天，伊曼鲁刚刚捡来一块废弃的地毯，他兴奋至极，正在积极地装饰自己的睡房。伊曼鲁在厕所旁挖地3尺，制作了简易的排水系统，小便能够直接排入土地之下。 他也为自己制作了一个可移动的座厕。在他的巧手之下，所有被抛弃的废物都有成为精致家居用品的潜能。伊曼鲁考虑十分周到，他在自己的睡房前设置有一个暗格，厕所旁备有一袋灭火土。他说，生活在森林里，防火设施必不可少。就在前几天，森林才刚刚遭遇过一次火警。夜幕降临，森林里没有电力，这个无家可归社区伴随着黑暗慢慢安静了下来，只有伊曼鲁借着我们摄像机的灯光继续装饰自己的家园。无独有偶，罗尼的帐篷虽然比不上伊曼鲁的精致，在这里却也算得上是豪宅了。在整个森林里，记者看到只有他的家设有发电机，在家里就能够收听音乐看电视，冰箱也能派上用场，厕所保持得十分整洁。屋门前的土地上，罗尼还精心打理着一串瓜藤。经过3年的上诉，最近法庭终于同意撤销其性犯罪者的身份。罗尼兴奋地告诉记者，这个仪器应该下星期就能脱下，而且在社工帮助下，几天后就能暂时搬入酒店。牢狱生活的极度不适应让他在2004年确诊为精神残疾。回到陌生的社会，他如今靠着残疾保障金和退休金过活。记者在几天后再次回到森林探访罗尼，帐篷下放满打包好的行李，罗尼却在电话的这一头哭泣。2天前，当罗尼带着行李到酒店下榻时，却被拒之门外。罗尼无可奈何，变得更加暴躁，他只能继续等待。罗尼最近在读一本书，叫做《超越自己的过去》。他总想重拾新生，但屡受挫折。离开时，记者发现罗尼门前的瓜藤不见了。他说，瓜藤已经打包到酒店去了。在这里，到处都能看到抛家傍路的购物车，一如他们的主人一样。阳光照不进森林，但居民的笑容却比阳光刺眼。他们脚下是一片荒废的泥土，他们的泪水比泥土更加沉重。他们是机灵者，于是他们聚集在这里，化为整数。他们筑起围栏，拒绝人们进入他们的天地。不过，其实他们是多么的需要别人走进他们的世界。